The Quran was revealed so that people would know how to deal with all the situations that they may encounter while in this world. In addition, the Sunnah of our Prophet, may God bless him and grant him peace, shows how to implement its teachings into one's life. There are various stories in the Quran about the lives of prophets and devout believers for the faithful to adopt as role models. One of those devout individuals whose excellent moral values should be reflected on and taken as a role model is Maryam. God introduces Maryam as having the character of the ideal Muslim woman. Maryam is one of the two women believers whom God reveals as an example to all the faithful in the Quran. God has made an example for those who believe, the wife of Pharaoh. And Maryam, the daughter of Imran, who guarded her chastity, we breathed our spirit into her, and she confirmed the words of her Lord and his book, and was one of the obedient. This character is completely different to the common character of women in today's unbelieving societies, where they usually share a common socially acceptable character handed down from their ancestors. In these societies, men and women are expected to conform to very different sets of character traits. According to the Quran, however, men and women have the same responsibilities and characters. According to historical sources, God honored Maryam, who lived approximately 2 millennia ago, with the birth of Prophet Isa, peace be upon him. Maryam was born in Palestine, which was under the dominion of the Roman Empire at that time. She was a Jewess and lived in the Jewish community. Idolatry was the widespread religion in Rome at that time. The Jews, on the other hand, had adopted false beliefs. Rebelled against God's commands and were no longer grateful for his gifts to them. Some of them even murdered the prophets sent to them by the grace of God. Maryam was born at a chaotic time, when the Jews' only hope was their expected Messiah or Savior. As someone chosen by God, she represented proper moral values and the true religion among these people's distorted and ignorant beliefs. Maryam was from the Imran family, whom the Quran describes as specially chosen. God chose Adam and Nuh, and the family of Ibrahim, and the family of Imran, over all other beings, descendants one of the other. When Imran's wife, a sincere believer, found out that she was pregnant with Maryam, she immediately prayed to God. She promised that she would dedicate her child to him. When she gave birth to a girl, she named her Maryam, which means Abida in Arabic, in other words, God's worshiper. With her faith, behavior, and moral values, Maryam became a major role model for all humanity. God made her grow in health and beauty, to use the Quran's expression, and gave her a very important responsibility. Maryam turned to God in all she did, sought his support and help, and knew that obeying his word would be sufficient for her. As a result of this sincerity in her faith and submission, she was always rewarded through the mercy of God. She had surrendered to God with a pure faith and was therefore unaffected by people's accusations and comments. By displaying his miracles, God enabled Maryam to see his mercy on, protection of, and compassion for her. For example, the way that Maryam always had food when worshiping is a clear sign of God's support for and mercy on her. Her Lord accepted her with approval and made her grow in health and beauty. And Zakaria became her guardian. Every time Zakaria visited her in the sanctuary, he found food with her. He asked, "Maryam, how did you come by this?" She said, "It is from God. God provides for whoever he wills without any reckoning." Maryam experienced many miracles throughout her life. One of these was her encounter with Jibril. After a certain period of her life, Maryam departed from the society she lived in and her family and retired to a place in the east. Her encounter with Jibril took place at this time. In the Quran, God reveals that Jibril appeared to Maryam in the guise of a handsome, well-built man. Mention Maryam in the book, how she withdrew from her people to an eastern place and concealed herself from them. Then we sent our spirit to her, and it took on for her the form of a handsome, well-built man. Not knowing that it was Jibril, she sought refuge with God and told him that she held God in the utmost fear and respect. She said, "I seek refuge from you with the All-Merciful. Leave me if you fear God." Her words clearly demonstrate her complete trust in God, as well as the importance she placed upon chastity and devotion to God. Jibril revealed that he was a messenger of God's and that he had come to her with glad tidings from him. When the angels said, "Maryam, your Lord gives you good news of a word from him. His name is the Messiah, Isa, son of Maryam, of high esteem in this world and the hereafter, and one of those brought near." ¶¶ Maryam asked Jibril how she could have a child when no man had ever touched her. My Lord, how can I have a son when no man has ever touched me? He said, It will be so. God creates whatever he wills. When he decides on something, he just says to it, Be, and it is. By the will of God, Maryam became pregnant with Isa, although no man had ever touched her. Her pregnancy was independent of this world's usual cause and effect relationship. The circumstances of his conception were among the features of Isa's miracle. He said, It will be so. Your Lord says, That is easy for me. It is so that we can make him a sign for humanity and a mercy from us. It is a matter already decreed. So she conceived him and withdrew with him to a distant place. After she had conceived, at God's will, Maryam withdrew to an isolated place. There is, without a doubt, great wisdom in Maryam spending her pregnancy in an isolated spot. One element of this is that in this way, God kept her away from the disturbing behavior of people who would be unable to understand this miraculous state of affairs. God fully supported Maryam throughout her pregnancy. It is very difficult for a woman to give birth, a potentially life-threatening experience, all alone, without medical equipment or a midwife's assistance. Nevertheless, Maryam overcame all of these difficulties by placing her complete trust in God. He helped her with revelations while she was struggling towards a date tree in the full throes of labor. The pains of labor drove her to the trunk of a date palm. She exclaimed, Oh, if only I had died before this time, and was something discarded and forgotten. A voice called out to her from under her, Do not grieve. Your Lord has placed a small stream at your feet. Shake the trunk of the palm toward you, and fresh, ripe dates will drop down to you. Eat and drink and delight your eyes. There is also great wisdom in the way that God tells Maryam not to grieve and to eat dates, and that he had created a small stream for her. There are indications of various methods of facilitating birth in all these verses. God commanded Maryam not to grieve, but to keep her spirits up. Modern medicine has shown that it is most important for mother and baby, for a pregnant woman, or one about to give birth, to avoid stress and to maintain a positive state of mind. In the same verses, it is reported that God commanded Maryam, who was suffering from labor pains, to shake a date branch towards her. Doctors say that pulling something toward oneself during labor can have a positive effect on the muscles. In order to ease labor pains and help bring about a safe delivery, women are advised to do certain exercises that reduce pressure in the body and, therefore, the risk of complications during delivery. They are also thought to quicken the process of giving birth. Another thing emphasized in the verses is dates. Today, such dates are considered to be a food and medicine. Scientists now know that dates contain more than 10 substances considered essential for the human body's well-being and continued good health. Scientists now inform us that people can survive on dates and water for years because they contain all of the necessary essentials for human life. Dates provide energy, help muscle tissues and nerve cells develop, and are especially beneficial for people weakened by illness or those suffering from exhaustion because of their high calorific value. Modern medical findings suggest that dates benefit women who are almost ready to give birth. Doctors now advise pregnant women to take fructose-containing foods on their due dates, for such foods provide energy used by the weakened body to revitalize itself. The substance known as oxytocin, which is found in dates, is used as a drug to make giving birth easier. Oxytocin is used in modern medicine to accelerate labor and is often referred to as rapid birth. It also increases the level of milk production following birth. We may list a few of the benefits from the vitamins and minerals in dates for the normal human body and during pregnancy, thus. They contain folic acid, an essential vitamin for pregnant women. It meets the body's need for potassium, caused by physical reactions and long-term nausea during pregnancy. It meets the body's increased need for vitamin A during pregnancy. Most fruits are poor in protein, but the protein in dates helps protect the body against disease and infections. The iron in dates prevents anemia during pregnancy. All of our current information on dates reveals God's infinite wisdom and grace upon Maryam, who, inspired by God, might have satisfied all her nutritional needs by eating dates and thereby easing her child's birth. God knows best, of course. God created a stream for Maryam. In addition to dates, God also created a stream for Maryam. We know that water is important in various regards during pregnancy. Even just the sight or sound of water can automatically regulate the actions of the muscles. Water, like dates, eases labor pains and regulates muscle tension. In fact, some modern birth clinics have pools in which the delivery takes place. Water intake is especially necessary because the volume of blood increases and because of the developing baby's needs. Women who choose to breastfeed need plenty of water to produce the necessary amount of milk. These facts, that science has only uncovered in our own time, reveal a great many miracles in the verses of the Quran dealing with Maryam's pregnancy. When Maryam returned with Isa, her people could not comprehend God's miracle. Thus, they accused her of indecency and slandered her. God reveals some of these slanders. She brought him to her people, carrying him. They exclaimed, "Maryam, you have done an unthinkable thing. Sister of Harun, your father was not an evil man, nor was your mother an unchaste woman." No doubt this was a trial for Maryam. So, as always, she turned toward God and trusted in him, knowing that he would defend her in the best possible way. God revealed to Maryam that when she returned to her people, she should say that she had vowed not to speak to anyone. If you should see anyone at all, just say, "I have made a vow of abstinence to the All-Merciful, and today I will not speak to any human being." When Maryam returned to her people, she indicated Isa to those who slandered her. In this way, God performed a great miracle and caused Isa to speak while he was still in the cradle. God caused Isa to utter the explanation her people were expecting from Maryam, both exonerating her from the slanders and, through a miracle, telling the children of Israel about Isa's prophethood. She pointed toward him. They asked, "How can a baby in the cradle speak?" He said, "I am the servant of God. He has given me the book and made me a prophet. He has made me blessed wherever I am, directed me to perform prayer and give alms, zakat, as long as I live, and to show devotion to my mother. He has not made me insolent or arrogant. Peace be upon me the day I was born, and the day I die, and the day I am raised up again alive. That is Isa, son of Maryam, the word of truth about which they are in doubt." This miraculous speech revealed Maryam's honorable and pure nature, and foiled the traps of the unbelievers in the best possible way. One very evident fact can be seen when one looks at the societies of the world in general. There are many unemployed and needy women in many countries of the world who suffer from violence and abuse. Yet for some reason, no lasting solution to this problem has been found. Yet this impasse stems entirely from the fact that the solution is being sought in the wrong place. As in all matters, the only solution lies in abiding by the moral values of the Quran. Many people are unaware of the importance and value Islam places upon women. These people who do not know this reality, as well as all others with insufficient knowledge of the Quran, try to protect their rights by working within their worldview, which follows the logic of unbelief. They are therefore unable to find a lasting solution. Islam attaches great importance to women. Through many verses of the Quran, God has placed women and women's rights under protection. In societies that live far removed from the moral values of the Quran, there are certain values to which people attach enormous importance and on which they expend enormous energy throughout their lives. Factors such as someone being rich and esteemed, having a particular career and becoming famous, or being physically attractive, are of the greatest importance for people who have adopted this false perspective. Although these criteria of superiority may vary from society to society, their broad lines are generally the same. At the root of ongoing discussions regarding women's proper role lie the very same wrong criteria. By applying their society's misguided tradition and self-made criteria, they continue to treat women as second-class citizens. Yet when we look at the Quran, we see that God reveals that taqwa, or piety, is the sole measure of superiority among human beings. O humanity, we created you from a male and a female, and made you into peoples and tribes, so that you might come to know each other. The noblest among you, in God's sight, is the one with the most taqwa. God is all-knowing, all-aware. Thus, those who measure superiority in terms of gender, physical strength, or any other value built upon unbelief are making a great mistake. The only superiority is that of faith and taqwa as revealed by God. Matters such as women's status in society, their importance to family life, and whether or not they should work have been important subjects of debate all over the world for many years. Yet for a Muslim, women's place in society is crystal clear, because Islam states that men and women are fully equal. According to Islamic moral values, what matters is not whether someone is a man or a woman, but their devotion to God with a deep faith and awed fear, and their striving to abide by the moral values of the Quran. It is these characteristics of people that will be appreciated in the sight of God. For women who abide by Quranic moral values, the question is not one of striving for equality with men, but in competing to commit auspicious deeds. Such competition shows that believers spend their lives doing all in their power to obtain God's approval. In the Quran, God reveals that it is these endeavors that will bring people to the fore in this world and the next. Such people are truly racing toward good things, and they are the first to reach them. In the Quran, God emphasizes the importance of good behavior displayed towards mothers. Parents do their best to give their children a good education, a decent character, and teach them to act properly. A person must have respect for this altruism and appreciate the efforts made on his or her behalf. God advises people not to forget their parents' selfless devotion to them and to treat them equally well. Your Lord has decreed that you should worship none but Him and that you should show kindness to your parents. Whether one or both of them reach an old age with you, do not say "Ugh" to them out of irritation. and do not be harsh with them. Rather, speak to them with gentleness and generosity. Take them under your wing, out of mercy, with due humility, and say, O Lord, show mercy to them as they did in looking after me when I was small. It is a person's faith and fear of God that beautifies and strengthens their character, and that makes them superior. As they do for all people, the moral values of the Quran bestow the strongest, healthiest, and most beautiful characteristics on women. Muslim women believe in God with a true heart, submit completely to Him, are aware that there is no other deity, that He is the Lord of every being and thing, and that He is all-powerful. God gives good news to those who submit to Him. Not so. All those who submit themselves completely to God and are good doers will find their reward with their Lord. They will feel no fear and will know no sorrow. Since they take the Quran as their guide, Muslim women always behave in the correct manner, take wise decisions, and therefore obtain the best results in all they do. They live far removed from the stresses and troubles inflicted on women by irreligion. Immaturity and a failure to behave rationally and reasonably when the right thing conflicts with one's own desires are forms of behavior that humiliate one. The fact is, however, that the noble and best thing to do against the evil insinuations of one's earthly desires is to guard against them and follow one's conscience. Muslim women have the dignity and character to reject such debasing behavior for small gains. God draws attention to this powerful, immovable, and honorable character in the Quran. O you who believe, if any of you renounce your religion, God will bring forward a people whom He loves and who love Him. Humble to the believers, fierce to the unbelievers, who strive in the way of God and do not fear the blame of any censurer. That is the unbounded favor of God, which He gives to whoever He wills. God is boundless, all-knowing. Unbelievers think that being emotional is an important part of the human character. According to this view, the resulting behavior is a feeling that needs to be experienced. Such behavioral defects as being angry, upset, and introverted, or weeping, complaining, and apathy are encouraged, for they supposedly come from the heart. This view is completely wrong. Muslim women know the selfish ego's qualities and how to fight them, for their personalities and lives are defined by the Quran. Muslim women guard themselves against all such behavioral defects out of their strong love and fear of God. God has made Maryam a role model for all subsequent generations. God has chosen you and purified you. He has chosen you over all other women. God reveals the perfect character of a Muslim woman in that of Maryam. All the moral attributes for which men are held responsible in the ideal Muslim character described in the Quran also apply to women. Everyone, be they man or woman, must be devoted to God with a sincere love. They must live in a manner that will be pleasing to our Lord, holding Him above all things. Everyone who lives by such a sincere faith will, by the will of God, enjoy the greatest reward in His sight. Men and women who are Muslims, men and women who are believers, men and women who are obedient, men and women who are truthful, men and women who are steadfast, men and women who are humble, men and women who give alms, men and women who fast, men and women who guard their chastity, men and women who remember God much. God has prepared forgiveness for them and an immense reward.